How tall you are is obviously an important factor in setting drum throne height, but that's not the only thing you want to consider. Today we're finding your perfect formula for the perfect drum stool height by examining three factors. Hey, welcome to the Non-Glamorous Drummer. I believe that no matter who you are, you can master the drums. You can conquer the instrument when you're armed with the right know-how. And I believe this video is going to help you do just that. And also grab my free e-guide below about solving hi-hat frustration, improving that left foot coordination and technique. That's going to help you out a bunch. Totally free in the description. My stool height is 22 inches. So from the floor to the top of the seat cushion, 22 inches. And of course, the amount of squish in that cushion is going to be a factor here, because by the time I sit into it, I'm probably actually 21 inches. And so this is going to vary depending on what kind of stool you have. My height is about 76 inches. So if we do the math there, that gives us a roughly 3.45:1 ratio, or 29%. So we could say that my throne height is 29% of my height. But also, I'm a heel down player. And so that's going to be a factor we're going to get to in a minute. And so take that for what it's worth. If you want to use this as a starting point, by all means, maybe you're a heel down player like me, and you want to figure out what 29% of your height is and adjust your stool to that. That's a great starting point. But there are a lot of other things we want to think about. Two main other factors we really want to dig into here. I also want to give you an additional tip that's going to help improve your posture if you've been dealing with any kind of back pain. And so we'll get to that in a minute too. So a really big factor is, what foot technique are you using? Are you playing heel up or are you playing heel down? If you're playing heel up, you're probably going to want to sit higher. If you're playing heel down, you're probably just fine sitting lower. If you think about it logically, if you're sitting on like a bar stool in your kitchen, that means you're sitting pretty high, probably higher than you would at the drum set. But just tapping your toes on the floor from a bar stool feels very natural. Heel up feels natural. It might even be a stretch to plant your heel on the floor because you're so high up. Versus if you were to sit on your couch, if you sit down on your sofa in your living room, especially if it's a low couch, it's going to feel really weird to try to play heel up because you're going to have to manually lift your leg, which is awkward. So if you're sitting lower, it makes a lot more sense to plant the heel. So it's all just logical. It totally makes sense. If you haven't thought through that before, it is kind of interesting, and it does totally make sense that how high you sit is going to influence which technique you use, and vice versa. If you have a chosen foot technique, let your stool height reflect that technique. So higher if you're playing heel up, lower if you're playing heel down. I have a theory, and I've found this to be true pretty much 99% of the time. You can argue with me in the comments if you want to, or maybe you agree with this. You can let me know that a lot of times shorter people and younger kids tend to gravitate toward heel up playing, whereas taller people gravitate toward heel down playing. Pretty much every tall student I've had, somebody, you know, 6 foot plus, close to my height, because I'm 6'4", they tend to do heel down. Meanwhile, I've had very young students, like 8 years old, where they sit down at the drum set and they end up playing heel up. And the reason why, so from my standpoint as a tall person, the first drum set I ever had, I was actually sitting lower than I should have sat. I was using a piano bench as my drum stool with my first drum set. And then even years later, as I played on other people's kits, I was sitting down at kits that were adjusted for shorter people. So I was still sitting too low. And so because I was sitting so low, my technique naturally became heel down. Heel up would have felt weird. Meanwhile, kids who start playing drums when they're still small, they end up sitting down in a kit that's actually adjusted for somebody much taller than them. And so it's the equivalent of me sitting on a bar stool, where it feels much more natural to play heel up. And maybe their heel doesn't reach the floor, and so we have to lower the stool to make that work. I've noticed almost all the time younger kids would rather play heel up. And in general, shorter drummers do tend to play heel up, taller drummers play heel down. So you might notice that's true with you, or it's not true. If that's not the case with you, let me know in the comments below. I am interested to hear from you about that. Now, another factor here is, how far back from the kick do you want to sit, or how close do you want to sit? What feels natural to you? Because if you're wanting to sit closer, you're going to need to sit higher to compensate, because you've got to make sure that you've got a 90 degree angle or greater between upper leg and lower leg, because we want to either be sitting like this, or maybe we could sit like this if the bass drum pedal's down here. We want to make sure it's greater than 90 degrees, so we can sit close if we're sitting really high. So maybe that's your comfort zone. Maybe you want to sit closer. Great. Make sure you've got your throne adjusted higher so that your leg isn't cramped. Or maybe you're fine with it being further away, but if you're a heel down player, that means you've got to sit pretty far back. So if you're sitting closer, you need to be higher. And if you're sitting further back, you're probably going to need to be lower. Also, if you're playing heel down, you'll need to be further back to give your leg enough room. But if you're playing heel up, you can get away with being closer. So you can see how all those things relate. Hopefully that all makes sense. So back to my 29% ratio. So that can be a great starting point if you're heel down. And my guess is that that might be a 35% ratio or so on, maybe even 40% if you're playing heel up. But it all depends on your personal preference, and ultimately depends on what makes you comfortable. Because if we go back to what we said in the title, how do you find your perfect drum stool height? Well, all these factors play into that. But ultimately, the perfect drum stool height is whatever allows you to be relaxed, but sitting with good posture, not have back pain, not have knee pain, be able to play really well and comfortably whatever technique you're using, and just not to feel unbalanced. Basically, as long as you feel relaxed, you feel balanced, you're able to play the technique you want to play, no back pain, and everything's good, that's your perfect drum stool height. Now, how do you get there? Well, it can take a little bit of time. You just have to experiment. That's why I say start with that ratio and then make adjustments according to your technique. And just think about all those variables and how, you know, sitting higher affects how far back you want to be and how heel down affects this and that. So be thinking through that so that you can get there more quickly. That's the point of this whole discussion. I want to help you get there more quickly. Now, the type of stool can also be a factor. Sometimes the reason you have back pain isn't your fault. So just because you're experiencing pain, just because you're not feeling balanced, it might not be your fault. Yes, we can all build more core strength. We can all do some more sit-ups. We can all spend time sitting on a yoga ball. Building more core strength is always going to help. But sometimes the stool itself just isn't the best stool for your body type. I know drummers who have had a lot of success with the type of stool that has the backrest. Now, for me, that doesn't make sense. And I think it's because I'm skinny, I'm tall and lanky. And so for me to actually utilize the backrest, I would have to slouch into it. And so that's bad. That backrest would cause me to have worse posture. But depending on your build, if that backrest is helping support your lower back and reducing the lower back pain, but you're still sitting up straight, you're still maintaining good posture, that's perfect. I can't argue with that. And so sometimes you just gotta find what's comfortable and what you can sit evenly on. Maybe a bicycle seat stool is right for you. Maybe a round one is right. Maybe a lot of squish, less squish, backrest, no backrest. You just gotta experiment. Now, as you're working on the right foot technique and you're figuring out, okay, how do I need to sit for making my right foot work? Don't forget about that left foot too, because remember that you might be using heel up for some left foot hi-hat stuff, but you might be using heel down for other things. And so you wanna kind of, you know, keep that in the back of your mind as you're adjusting how you sit. You definitely wanna have your right leg very comfortable. It gets priority, but make sure your left foot is also comfortable. If you're wanting to dig a little more into that and learn more about left foot technique, left foot coordination, you know, how to play chicks, splashes, sizzles, how to make all that stuff work on your hi-hats and get them adjusted just right, I've got a totally free e-guide just for you to go check out that's going to take you through the steps to do that. So if you're wanting to really improve your left foot, go through a crash course of just figuring out the hi-hat, solving hi-hat frustrations, solving issues that have gone on with your left foot, then go check that out. It's totally free. Hey, I mentioned a few minutes ago I'd give you a really important additional tip for just improving your posture. Something that's helped me a lot is sitting more on the front edge of my stool. So instead of sitting back into it and kind of settling into it, if I sit more toward the middle and maybe even toward the front, I'm able to better sit up straight, and that just helps me maintain that mindset of good posture. And I know that's different for everybody. I know that for some people it feels more natural to kind of sit into it a little bit more. For me, it causes me to slouch. And so again, it could be a body type thing. Maybe if you're tall and skinny, it's just a tall and skinny issue where you've got to sit a little closer to the front to make sure you're sitting up straight, versus maybe if you're, you know, a thicker build, then maybe it doesn't matter so much. So I just want to throw that out there, because if you have had issues with slouching, it could be if you're using a really soft, squishy throne, then maybe you're sitting too far back into it. And also it could be tilting a little bit depending on the throne and how it's adjusted. And so sit more toward the middle, maybe even towards the front edge, just so you can sit up and just make sure you're sitting straight the whole time. All right, that is all today. Thanks so much for watching. I hope this video really helped you out. Hope it provided you with some value, gave you just some good thinking points toward getting your stool comfortable. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe before you go. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'll see you next week.